did you know that smokeless charcoal exists in Ghana and even in Africa? Bidigreen Ghana Limited, a company located in Kumasi, is doing amazing with its extraordinary charcoal that presents extra and amazing features. This is what we bring you on R&D Africa on AAU TV. Stay tuned, we'll bring you more.
Bidigreen Ghana Limited is a renewable energy company that focuses on producing charcoal produced from crop waste, mostly coconut husk and palm kernel shells. But we also rely on a variety of raw materials available based on demand. Now, Bidigreen burns 3 times longer, it is smokeless, and an efficient source of energy for cooking.
Firewood has for so long been a major source of energy for domestic purposes. Along the line, innovative minds realized that a better substitute could be made out of firewood just by burning them. And that is how charcoal is traditionally made.
The first criteria for production is to have very dried raw materials with a moisture content of about from 0 to 15% to make production efficient. And it takes about 6 hours to fully carbonize all the crop waste. What really makes Bidigreen innovative is the smokeless feature of the charcoal.
Cooks all over the world have been exposed to much more advanced means of cooking, such as a gas and electric stove. And although charcoal has been substituted with better options, its relevance has not entirely been relegated. Till date, a wide range of people find major usefulness for charcoal, as it is being used by kebab sellers, household cooks, industrial cooks, amongst others.
Bidigreen is a climate-centered company involved in the renewable energy sector, and our main aim is to provide an alternative raw material to producing charcoal instead of using hardwood source charcoal. Hence, all our activities are centered around pushing for a more sustainable environment with our waste source charcoal.
Many users of charcoal tend to complain about the excess ashes it produces, its weight and high consumption, its inability to be regulated, and its hazardous effect. It is in the midst of these complaints by charcoal users comes an innovative solution by Bidigreen Ghana Limited, a group of 3 students from the Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology. These innovative minds came together to produce charcoal that is 3 times stronger than the usual charcoal on the market. It has a smokeless feature. It is molded to suit specific purposes among other innovative features. So we are currently at where Bidigreen Ghana Limited produces its extraordinary charcoal. This is where it begins, and we'll take you through the process. But before then, I have with me here the co-founder of Bidigreen Ghana Limited, and I'll have him introduce himself.
Well, I'm Emmanuel Obin
Frimpong.
Okay. I'm in charge of production at Bidigreen Ghana Limited.
Okay, it's nice meeting you. And I can see you guys are doing great and massive job here. I'm actually very impressed. So quickly take us through the process of converting these coconut husks, among other raw materials, to make the activated charcoal.
Okay, so as you can see, this is a raw material, coconut husk. Yeah. Mm-hmm. We also have palm kernel shell, and then corn cobs. These are a number of raw materials we use here. So we first outsource and then we dry them. And after drying, we process it into the carbonizer, where we carbonize it under controlled conditions and high temperature to achieve a carbonized product. So that is the char. So after it takes about 5 to 8 hours in carbonizing. So after that, we mill, we take you through the milling process, addition of our binder, mixing, and we then mold it into the various shapes based on the customer's specification.
Okay. So do you have a specific quantity of the coconut husk combined with other raw materials that you have to use?
Our trade secret. We have a combination of those various raw materials. We combine it in various proportions in order to achieve the customer specification. So that makes our product more exceptional. okay. compared to the other okay. products that use just one product raw material.
Okay.
But ours, we use some of the products, we use a combination of the various raw materials. Okay, so this is the palm kernel shell. Yeah, this we are currently sun drying it. Based on our infrastructure, we just do sun drying. So we are waiting for it to dry. We've already filled the carbonizer with some of the palm kernel shell. So once we are done with that, we will fill and we go on continue with the process. So basically, this is how it is. This is our carbonizer. This is where we do the carbonizing of the raw materials after it's been sun dried or it's been dried. So there are three chambers within the carbonizer. We fill each of the cylinders or chambers with the raw materials.
Okay.
And we apply the heat through this section.
Okay.
So it will heat it, and it's an enclosed system. So in order to prevent the smoke out and causing other environmental hazards, so mm-hmm. it's an enclosed system
okay.
that tries to control the flow of the smoke.
Okay.
Yes,
okay.
In a very controlled manner.
Okay. Does that in any way contribute to the fact that once your charcoal is ready, it doesn't produce smoke?
Not necessarily. Once we are carbonizing, definitely we are trying to get rid of some compounds within the raw materials.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. So definitely it would try to escape.
Mm-hmm.
So that is another aspect of it.
Okay.
With the carbonizing, definitely once it carbonizes, there wouldn't be any smoke coming out from the carbonized product.
Okay.
Uh-huh. But right now our system is designed in a way that it prevents extra pollution whilst we are processing the raw materials.
The
smokeless nature of our product is after we've carbonized it. Within the carbonizing process, we ensure that it prevents pollution.
Okay.
Uh-huh. And after that, the product that is being churned out is also a product that is smokeless and it is harmless.
Okay, so I can see that there are different charcoals here, and I think it all comes in different shapes.
Yeah.
Do you have any specific reason for making your charcoals that way?
Okay, so over the years we started, we've gone to modify most of our products from different shapes, basically based on the customer demand. Some comes with customer specification, and also in this, the various shapes enhance its quality in terms of burning.
Okay.
So you can see that this one has hole in it.
Okay.
With the hole, basically what it does is it enhances its fast drying.
Okay.
Because there's enough air circulation and heat penetration.
Okay.
And also in terms of burning, it enhances its burning because the hole allows air penetration.
Okay.
So basically this is the reason. And with this one, some also use this is a pellet size. The pellet size,
this doesn't look as heavier as this.
Yeah, because it's smaller.
Okay.
This is smaller size. And this is the largest size. This is the stick form. Uh-huh. This is more we use a different machinery for this, and this also use different machinery.
Okay.
Uh-huh. So this one mostly is for the barbecue.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Mostly for slow heating. For grilling and for roasting and those things. That's what we use these for.
Okay.
For large cooking, basically.
Okay. Okay.
So with this one, it's quite heavier, durable as well. So placing heavy load on it wouldn't really break it as compared to this smaller sized one. So that's basically the difference. So this, as it has an enhanced air penetration circulation for heat, continuous heat. It also is very durable. That's preventing breakage and used for large cooking. For large cooking in the restaurants, in the chop bars, in their homes.
Okay.
And this is basically for home grilling. And then
Personally, I've had the chance to use quite a number of charcoals, and I don't think I've come across any charcoal that is as heavy as the ones I see here. I mean, why is it like that?
Okay, so as I said earlier on, it's not just about one product. We don't just have one product in here. So it's a combination of different raw materials. That's also enhances its heaviness.
Okay.
Realize that palm kernel has a heavier weight.
Okay.
Compared to the coconut shell.
Coconut.
As well as rice husk and also the corn cobs, the various raw materials we use. So a combination of that brings about the heaviness.
Okay.
Yes. So okay. Basically, that's defines. Okay. The differences in the weight.
Okay. And also you've mentioned quite a number of features, but does your charcoal present any other additional features that the ones on the market do not present?
Well, as you just said, it's very heavy, durable.
Yeah, extremely
so
heavy.
I should tell you that it takes very long time to burn, fully burn. Mm-hmm. And one amazing thing is that even after burning, once you've exhausted the entire thing, the ash, you could also use it for warming of your food stuff. Whether you are warming water or you want to heat your food or anything like that, just the ash.
Okay.
It's
okay.
Good for okay. Just the warming.
Okay.
So it's a whole new product on its own.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. It lasts longer.
Mm-hmm.
It's smokeless nature as mm-hmm. well, and its durability.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So and its high heat intensity. In terms of its calorific value, it's very high. It has a very high intensity okay. compared to the local made charcoal.
Okay.
So with its durability, you could say that one would also say that it's very cost effective in a sense that once it's burning 2 to 3 times longer than the traditional charcoal,
mm-hmm.
you could use like about 4 bags of the traditional charcoal and probably you are using just 1.5 of mm-hmm. our charcoal.
Mm-hmm.
So looking at it from the cost effective wise, mm-hmm. it is very, very cost effective.
Okay. The Bidigreen team provides green means of using charcoal with long-lasting features. This is where we end this episode of RnD Africa on AAU TV with Bidigreen located in the Ashanti region of Ghana. And I hope you had a great show. Follow AAU TV for more content. My name is Maame Ekua Otuakoa Nyame.